When you're faced with a decision, are you making decisions based on your intellect or your gut? Are you making decisions based on fear or inspiration? Are you making decisions from your left brain or your right? Also known as Mr. Spock and Captain Kirk. There's literally a scene in Star Trek between Dr. Spock and Captain Kirk, and it is if the right and left brains were personified, brought to life, and are having a conversation. It's as if your limbic brain and your prefrontal cortex are actually having a conversation, because that's what those are. Your right brain is your limbic system. Your left brain is your prefrontal cortex. Dr. Spock, okay? He makes decisions based on data, rationality. Is that a word, rationality? Great, rationality. We'll go with it. and predictions, right? He's always analyzing the data from the past and predicting the potential data from the future, right? This is the left brain's job. Now, Captain Kirk is very much right brain. He's very much, he's like a 20-something young, doesn't have any experience dude. He just has a lot of raw talent. And they were having this conversation about what to do with the ship, right? And Mr. Spock is like, you know, I don't think we should do it because of this and because of this and because of this, and the prediction that we will fail is this and this and this. And he goes to Captain Kirk, and Captain Kirk is like, yep, we're doing it. And he's like, I think this is a very bad idea. And Captain Kirk's like, great, we're doing it anyway. We're going. And he's like, but why? I don't understand your rationale. I don't understand your reasoning. And Captain Kirk's like, I don't know. I can't explain it. I just feel it in my gut. We're going. And, you know, of course it goes well. Why? Because when we make decisions based on our gut, our intuition, our limbic brain is smarter than we are. It is the piece of us that is connected to all that is, right? We are all just different waves on this one ocean of consciousness. We are all just different waves on this one ocean of energy, right? So if you can tap into your right brain, if you can tap into your intuition, to that still, small, quiet voice that never leads you astray, that thing has access to more information and more knowledge than you have access to in your limited left brain human perception of this life. When we don't know what to do, when the channels to our gut, the channels to our inner Captain Kirk get blocked, that's when we really rely on our intellect. That's when we start to reason and rationalize and pro and con things out, because we need all this data to support our choices, because we've lost our ability to connect with that gut voice, that visceral thing that just knows the right answer. So what we have to do is we have to listen every day. We have to clear those channels. We have to get rid of the stress and the noise blocking us from listening to that voice. Meditation is one of the ways to do that. Yoga is one of the ways to do that. Sitting still, breathing, dancing, sex, surfing, music, all of these things will open up the channels to your inner Captain Kirk. But when you're faced with a decision and you're not really sure what to do, what you gotta do is you gotta close your eyes, you gotta take some breaths, you gotta settle into that least excited state of awareness, and you gotta ask yourself, what do I want to do? What do I want to do? Even if it doesn't make any sense. As a matter of fact, especially when it doesn't make any sense. This is nature's GPS. This is nature trying to direct us and guide us, and we have to listen to it. I'm always saying this, that nature is trying to use us as a vehicle to deliver our fulfillment. In our creative pursuits, nature is trying to use us as a vehicle for creativity. And if we don't listen to that thing in our lives, it's going to be much harder to listen to it in our creative pursuits. And if we don't listen to it in our creative pursuits, it's much harder to listen to in our lives. The good news here is that the more that we listen in either of those instances, in our work or in our life, they're going to up-level each other, right? And it becomes easier to listen and easier to act on inspiration and easier to listen to our inner Captain Kirk. Now, I'm not saying that Mr. Spock is irrelevant, okay? I'm not saying that data is bad. I'm not saying that it's wrong to pro and con things. All I'm saying is that no amount of data is going to back up a decision that doesn't feel right in your gut. And you all know it, you've all done it, you've all made decisions that weren't in accordance with what you knew to be true, and it always turns out less elegant than it could. And I know that you have all had those situations where you just did the thing that didn't make any sense. It didn't make any sense in the left brain, rational mind, but things turned out much more elegantly than we could have conceived in our left brain. So this is our job, to start to practice this, because we've all been taking our left brains to the gym, right? Think, take action, achieve, make money so we can be happy in the future. Think, take action, achieve, make money so we can be happy in the future. And our poor little right brains, our poor little inner Captain Kirks are atrophying, right? And what we gotta do is we gotta come back to balance. We gotta bring our inner Captain Kirk to the gym. We gotta take our right brain to the gym. We gotta listen to this still, small voice inside of us, because it will never lead you astray. Gleaming sun stars.